Raptor workers have raised the first Attis ever lotus ant.
Very good. I look forward to seeing how they integrate into the Raptor hierarchy. I'm afraid we've ran out of time. It doesn't matter if the nest isn't perfect. Run the experiment, then clear out the specimens and bleach the equipment.
Yes, yes, I know. I'm doing it.
And when you are finished here, I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
What was that?
Nothing. Starting the experiment.
Good. Let me know when you have a result.
Okay, my little ants. This is it. The winner will have the privilege of joining me for the ultimate test. The real final experiment. The loser will be relegated to the waste disposal. The Formicariums are connected. Let the war commence! I wonder which colony will strike first. The Eruptors finally meet! Interesting combinations. I wonder which is more effective. Quickly, my little Eruptors. You wouldn't want to be caught by the finger of death! Most of our Eruptors are fighting very far from their nest. I wonder, what would happen if their queen was threatened? Yes, these mole crickets should reveal the relevant behaviors. Oh, dear. Could our colony be in trouble? Be careful, my queen. I haven't finished with you yet. Perhaps this new colony will prove to be a superior research subject.
This small leafcutter colony has established a foothold in a clearing near the base of a tree. Their location provides prime access to lucrative... An army ant scout has spotted the leafcutters. It must not be allowed to report back to the swarm. Against impossible odds, the soldiers of the Atta stronghold met the tyrannical intruders with ferocious defiance time and time again. Unable to break their lines and after tremendous losses, the army ant swarm has finally elected to move on. For the leafcutters, the ultimate trial is over.
Feeding time already?
Yes, our queen is insatiable.
this small leafcutter colony has established. Against impossible odds, the soldiers of the Atta stronghold met the tyrannical intruders with ferocious defiance time and time again. Unable to break their lines and after tremendous losses, the army ant swarm has finally elected to move on. For the leafcutters, the ultimate trial is over.
Feeding time already?
Yes, our queen is insatiable. Thank you.
This young queen has successfully raised her first daughters beneath the leaf litter of the rainforest floor. The nutritious fungus she fed them as larvae is now dwindling. If they don't find food quickly, they will all starve. These leaves are contested. The leafcutters will generally not attack unless provoked, but today there's too much at stake. Only a strong show of force will deter the opposing colony. The ants have subdued their rivals and achieved dominion over the clearing. As the competition withers, they will extend their territory in all directions, firmly establishing their agricultural empire. One day, this colony will number in the millions.
Is it feeding time already?
Yes, our queen is insatiable.
Thank you.
A number of small Formica, Rufa, and Fusca colonies have established themselves on this beach. Those nearest to the water's edge have enjoyed the first pick of the washed-up seafood for the past few days. However, as the sun and moon near alignment and the first spring tide of the month approaches, high tide draws nearer to these intrepid ants. Seemingly aware of their circumstances, these colonies are preparing to relocate to higher ground. There is only one way up the bank, and the route is currently occupied by a
I'm afraid we've ran out of time. It doesn't matter if the nest isn't perfect. Run the experiment, then clear out the specimens and bleach the equipment.
Yes, I know. I'm doing it.
And when you are finished here, I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
What was that?
Nothing, nothing. Starting the experiment.
Good. Let me know when you have a result.
Okay, my little ants. This is it. The winner will have the privilege of joining me for the ultimate test. The real final experiment. The loser will be relegated to the waste disposal. The Formicariums are connected. Let the war commence! I wonder which colony will strike first. The Eruptors finally meet. Interesting combinations. I wonder which is more effective. Things seem a little too easy for our Eruptors. Perhaps I should level the playing field. Excellent progress, my Eruptors. Strike at your nemesis. There can be only one. Our Eruptors are beating back the counterparts. Victory seems within their grasp. But what's this? Could it be the almighty hand of God? Oh, dear. Could our colony be in trouble? Be careful, my dear. I'm not finished with you yet. Most of our raptors are fighting very far from their nest. I wonder, what would happen if their queen was threatened? Yes, these mole crickets should reveal the relevant behaviors. Quickly, my little raptors. You wouldn't want to be caught by the finger of death! Pathetic, useless ants. Perhaps this new colony will prove to be a superior research subject.
A number of small Formica, Rufa, and Fusca colonies have established themselves on this beach. Those nearest to the water's edge have enjoyed the first pick of the washed-up seafood for the past few days. However, as the sun and moon near alignment and the first spring tide of the month approaches, high tide draws nearer to these intrepid ants. Seemingly aware of their circumstances, these colonies are preparing to relocate to higher ground. There is only one way up the bank, and the route is currently occupied by a small roofer colony. These defenders will have to hold their ground against the oncoming siege. It will be 3 days before the high tide washes away the competition. If the colony survives, it will inherit the beach. But this won't be an easy fight. Unfortunately for this colony, the Queen's choice of home could not have been worse. This stretch of beach is peppered with burrowed tiger beetle larvae. They lie, jaws primed, with only their armored heads visible from the sand. Anything that stumbles into their pit is speared and dragged below. Although the nests nearer the water have better access to the food washed up by the sea, this roofer colony need not starve. The plant life growing nearby is home to herds of grey aphids. As they feed on plant sap, these tiny insects excrete droplets of honeydew, which the wood ants find irresistible. They need only protect the aphids from danger to receive a constant supply of sugary liquid. Doing so is not always simple, however. Hungry ladybird beetles know exactly where the aphids like to graze. They can strip an unguarded stem bare in a mere matter of minutes. The ants will need to keep a close watch over their flock. The lower ground colonies have relented their siege for now. Night approaches, and with it, it brings a host of nocturnal predators out onto the beach. The high ground ants could go underground to wait out the night, but they would have to leave their precious aphids unguarded. It is a difficult choice for this colony. Face the peril out in the open, or hide away and risk losing their only reliable source of food. An ant has fallen victim to a beetle larva trap. They must watch their step. The voracious predators are difficult to see and lightning fast. More ants have been caught by tiger beetle larvae lying in wait. The colony is starving. There is not enough food to feed the new brood. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. Predators are loose in the nest. The larvae must be protected. There are intruders in the nest. There are intruders in the nest. Thank you. More ants have been caught by tiger beetle larvae lying in wait. Night falls, and a temporary truce emerges between the warring colonies. Once again, the high ground wood ants must make a choice. Do they defend the aphids, or will they hide, resting their forces until the morning? The workers have done all they can to improve these food stores. An ant has fallen victim to a beetle larva trap. They must watch their step. The voracious predators are difficult to see and lightning fast. The beetle larvae hiding in their burrows are eating well. Every ant lost to them diminishes the colony. More ants have been caught by tiger beetle larvae lying in wait. The beetle larvae hiding in their burrows are eating well. Every ant lost to them diminishes the colony. Dawn breaks, and the battle for the high ground will soon continue. The high ground colony defended their aphid flocks well, succeeding in securing vital food supplies to see them through the oncoming onslaught. More black ants are emerging from the Fusca nest. The colony is starving. There is not enough food to feed the new brood. The beetle larvae hiding in their burrows are eating well. Every ant lost to them diminishes the colony. More ants have been caught by tiger beetle larvae lying in wait. Last night's high tide was dangerously close to the low ground nests. Today is their last chance to relocate. The low ground colonies won't show any restraint. Their attacks will be desperately vicious. Fortunately for the high ground colony, many aphids survived the night. Access to food will be pivotal for the upcoming battle. A large black ant force has been sent from the Fusca nest. More wood ants are heading toward the high ground colony. Both lower ground colonies are now sending out armies at the same time. The day is almost over. The low ground is already starting to flood. The lower ground nests are emptying completely, and the ants are rushing up the bank. This is their final assault. The ants must fight. The wood ants upon the hill have finally defeated their would-be successors. Tomorrow their empire will expand to the undefended intertidal flats below, commanding both the aphid farms and the bounty of the sea. This colony will rise to become an undeniable power in the undergrowth.
Feeding time already?
Yes, our queen is in.
We've ran out of time. It doesn't matter if the nest isn't perfect. Run the experiment, then clear out the specimens and bleach the equipment.
Yes, yes, I know. I'm doing it.
And when you are finished here, I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
I think we should have a word about your conduct around the laboratory.
What was that?
Nothing, nothing. Starting the experiment.
Good. Let me know when you have a result.
Okay, my little ants, this is it. The winner will have the privilege of joining me for the ultimate test, the real final experiment. The loser will be relegated to the waste disposal. The Formicariums are connected. Let the war commence! I wonder which colony will strike first. The Eruptus finally meet. Interesting combinations. I wonder which is more effective. Things seem a little too easy for our Eruptus. Perhaps I should level the playing field. Excellent progress, my Eruptus. Strike at your nemesis. There can be only one. We'll be right back. Excellent progress, my Areptus. Strike at your nemesis. There can be only one. Yes. Perfect! I knew my Areptus would prevail. Now we can prepare for the real.
Have you finished yet?
Yes. Our Areptus have dominated the Formicarium.
Wonderful. I expect a full report by the end of the week. For now, you can start by clearing away. Make sure anything contaminated with that jelly goes straight to the incinerator.
Yes, yes, very good. Jelly to the incinerator. The jelly is for my aunts, and no one is going to take it away from you.